shouldn't talk about it. No, I want you. We can bring it on the floor. We've never danced like this before. We don't talk about it. Dancing on. Feel the boogie all night long. Stoned in paradise. Shouldn't talk about it. Shouldn't talk about it.
Here on 13 Folds versus the World on rifreeradio.org. And we are very fortunate to be joined by tonight's first guest, the great Mike Baker. What's going on, Mike?
Not too much. I don't know how fortunate you are, but...
but yeah, I'm learning how to talk into mics here for the first time in a while.
Well, thanks for coming on with us, man.
I've been trying to get you on the show for a while now, man. Yeah. We always just keep running into scheduling conflicts.
Yep, I'm a sick bastard. So
mentally or
both? Both. Yeah.
That's perfect. You're just our kind of scum.
I'm wearing Depends right now.
For the big moments in life, I double
this
up.
This is a big moment right now.
I wear two.
Feel great.
Having a heavy flow.
I'm about to shake a leg. Have
this
another
segment
meat pie.
Brought to you by Depends.
And this interview is off to just a really shitty start.
Well, that depends.
No, I meant that literally.
Oh, sorry.
So what's going on, man? What are you doing these days?
Drinking, walking around, you know. I live under a bridge right now. It's a really nice bridge. They just put it up. It's in Pawtucket. And
it's a new development then.
Yeah, yep.
That is a nice
new
bridge.
Development.
It's got the cool lights on it.
It's got the lights.
Yeah,
the blue
that's
lights,
an awesome
yeah.
bridge.
Dude,
if I was
right
going to live
pink
under
for
a bridge.
Breast cancer and like yeah. I'm all about that. Well, not all about breast cancer, but like
you should get a job.
It's a lot brighter than a blue or a purple, you know. Like I can see my shit now.
You should
know?
Get a job controlling the lights.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you're already there.
My dad's an electrician, so I mean halfway there.
So he helps out with the box payments.
It's in the genes, you know.
Another Depends reference.
He's got a bunch of boxes.
You know? So what, you got a new Sergeant Baker album coming out soon?
Yeah, probably like June.
Nice.
I'm pretty close. I just got to do the vocals, a couple little horn parts, and should be out pretty soon, hopefully.
Now, who else you got playing on that album with you?
We have Lee McAdams and Dewey Raposo from the Cosmic Factory,
nice.
Who I play bass for.
Nice.
And we have Andrew Sharp, who plays bass for the Clones. Couple people that are in my family, because I don't got to pay them, you know, because they're like family, you know, like they do favors and
it's
shit.
The same principle
know?
We use
it's
with
like,
the
don't
magazine.
Give me a Christmas present, just play on my album, and that's cool.
You got any neighbors from under the bridge helping out?
They're helping me out, like building my new house. I'm trying to get like a really steady thing going, like some drywall, some 2x4s.
You need the cardboard from those beer boxes, you know, the
double
bear
wall,
like a bear box.
The bear box.
What kind of a box do you keep a bear in?
A very strong,
very strong, sturdy box.
What kind of
box.
A bear are we talking about? A black bear, a brown bear,
a Guinness bear,
a polar bear,
yeah, a Guinness
it
bear,
a panda bear,
in,
a koala bear, a gay bear.
We call him
he's
bear,
in the box.
That bear's dick smells like shit, so we know he's a gay bear.
Wow.
That was sorry. That's your thing. That's cool. I'm not against any of that.
No, we support bear on bear sex. I guess
if it's done in a respectful manner, you know, I think that's what it comes down to. I don't like to see any zoo animals being exploited.
Oh wow! All right, so we're off to a great start here. All right, listen. The format for those of you who do not know is. You know, we like to bring our friends and musicians and fellow artists up on stage with us and, you know, let them talk about what they're doing. But more than that, we like to show how much better than them we are. So we challenge them every week to a contest of wits, you would say, or nitwits, depending.
Yeah, it's usually more nitwits, I think, than anything else. So, yeah, we've got a little Jeopardy-style trivia game for you. So you got a few different topics to choose from, and you can actually ask the audience. If you get stumped, we'll lean on the audience. They don't seem to have your back.
I'm asking the guy with the pink shirt.
Yeah,
over
he
there.
Looks like it's the
he
guy in the
like
pink
he
shirt.
Knows
that
all things
always,
good.
He always the pink shirt guy. It's not the same guy every week, but there's always a dude in a pink shirt that knows all the answers.
He
knows
everything. I can spit a spitball right at that bald spot in the back of his head.
So what we're gonna do is you can pick your topic, and you can pick your point total.
Okay.
So tonight's topics are classic wrestling trivia, primarily WWF from the 80s and a little bit from the 90s. We've got Beatles trivia in honor of the Sergeant Baker. We've got
I'm definitely choosing that one.
Princess Bride trivia. And we've got
Andre
a little
the Giant.
Bit of trivia ripped from the news, the most recent headlines from the
oh,
last
shit,
day
I'm
or
fucked.
Two.
Oh, yeah.
And most of these topics come with a point total of 100, 200 or 300 points.
Okay.
You're going to be playing against David primarily.
Okay.
Ah, ha, ha.
He has no foreknowledge of
bring it on.
Bullshit.
Joker.
So, is there a ask the producer button?
We could do an ask the producer. We're pretty freeform here. We stack the deck, but you know, we'll help you out a little bit.
Okay.
And most of these are multiple choice, so you should be all right, man.
Except for the Princess Bride.
I choose the Beatles one like a bunch of times.
You could do it. I got lots of Beatles questions.
All right, cool.
And I didn't think they were that hard. I took this quiz myself and I think I got a 75% right out of the gate. So, you want to lead off with the Beatles? 100,
yep.
200, or 300 points?
300 points. Let's
a
go for the
300 point question in the Beatles.
Oh, wait a minute. Do we both just get to like race to answer these, or does he get a chance? Do I have
we'll,
to wait
we'll
for him?
We'll give him
to
a question.
He and I get to answer it.
Nope. And then, like you, can, then you get a question.
Oh, all right.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Mike, your first question for 300 points under the Beatles category. Which song was not on the set list during the Beatles' Ed Sullivan Show appearance? Was it All My Loving, This Boy, From Me to You, or It Won't Be Long?
This Boy.
That is incorrect.
It was It Won't Be Long.
It was It Won't Be Long. I made the exact same mistake. I said This Boy, and I felt It Won't Be Long in my gut. I don't know how you folks down at the bar are doing. Feel free to play amongst yourselves. That is no points. David.
I'll take Loving This Boy for 300.
That's later. All right.
So,
you can pick. Now, it's up to you. Category?
You know what? I'm going to go Beatles for 10,000.
Beatles for 10,000. All right. Well, that's 300, but that's okay. All right. The working title of the song Yesterday was All My Troubles. Melancholy Love Song, Scrambled Eggs, or Why'd She Have to Go? What was the working title?
Scrambled Eggs.
It was Scrambled Eggs for 300.
Boom!
300 points for Dave.
Booyah! In your face, Baker.
All right.
Hey, go fuck yourself.
Let's keep it rolling. Mike, you want another Beatles question?
Yes,
you want to switch topics? All right. Point total, how much?
10,000. Fuck 10? Dave.
All right. Fuck Dave indeed. While we're talking about working titles,
yep.
What was the working title of the film Help? Was it Ringo's Big Adventure? I really wish that had been.
I wrote
like
a song about an octopus.
That's actually the direct-to-DVD porn that he did in the 80s.
Sounds like a Jay
we'll put this one on the
flick.
Fridge, Ringo.
Eight Arms to Hold You, I Need Somebody, or Ticket to Ride. What was the working title of the film Help? Ringo's Big Adventure, Eight Arms to Hold You, I Need Somebody, Ticket to Ride.
Eight Arms to Hold You.
It was indeed Eight Arms to Hold You for 300 points.
And
we got.
Have a tie.
I thought it was 10,000.
Well, no. Oh. It was 300. You
Why
said
Why Steve get 10,000 and
he
I
also,
get three?
Well, see, he got,
it's
he
my
three.
Show. It's my show.
All right, all right.
All right, guys. All right. Come on.
Indeed, it is.
David, the question is yours. Where do you want to go?
Let's go with.
We got Beatles, classic wrestling, The Princess Bride, or headlines in the news.
You know what? Let's go headlines in the news, wow. man. Let's.
All right.
Let's go.
Now, these headlines in the news questions are all worth 300 points, all right, because they're a little more difficult, and if you haven't been paying attention, you don't got a snowball's chance in hell. So for 300 points, the pressure cookers used by the Boston Marathon bombers were purchased at which big box department store? Walmart, Target, Bed Bath & Beyond, or Macy's?
I'm going to say Target just on principle.
And I heard someone in the bar said Target. They did do a lot of shopping. They did not get the pressure cookers at Target, though.
Aww.
Those were a Macy's exclusive item.
Oh, that was during the Macy's Day sale. I forgot.
So those damn Tsarnaev brothers screwed you again.
By the way, they're all on clearance now. Go for it.
Everything must go. It's a blowout.
All right, so we got one more question, then we got to go to some more music.
All right. You go ahead, man. What do you want to do? Beatles, wrestling, Princess Bride?
I'll do Princess Bride. What
Princess
the fuck? Why
Bride.
Not? We're tied, right? This is.
You guys are tied at 300 apiece. All right. How much do you want to go for? 100, 200, or 3?
I'm a bitch. I'm going to go for 100.
100.
For the win.
100. Okay. This is an easy one. Vizzini told Fezzik to finish off the Man in Black, quote unquote, his way. When Vizzini described what the way consisted of, Fezzik didn't like it. Why did Fezzik not like his way? No multiple choice. You need to know these questions. What was it that Andre the Giant did not like about his way?
1,500 for a steel, Alec.
Go ahead, Dave. What is it?
He didn't want to hurt him.
No. Who said that? Was that Kyle? It was not sportsmanlike. 100 points for the bar.
All right.
It was unsportsmanlike.
So we're going into the finals tied, man.
Tied
let's get some music. You know what? I got the new one from Alabama Shakes coming up for you guys right now. So stick around. You're listening to 13 Folds versus the World on RIFreeRadio.org.
Cheers.
What you like, what I like, why can't we both be right? No relief.